The name hockey has been accredited to the French word hockey, meaning shepherd's stick. It is estimated that hockey was introduced to North America by the military in the 19th century, who brought in similar stick and ball games like shinty, hurling or bandy. Montreal in Quebec, Windsor in Nova Scotia, and Kingston in Ontario have all claimed to be the birthplace of ice hockey, but there's little evidence. In 1875 in Montreal, the first game of organized ice hockey took place, where the McGill student James Creighton established a set of formal rules. The sport quickly spread across Canada and the US. In 1904, the first recognized professional league, the International Pro Hockey League, was formed. Early hockey was played in simple conditions, mostly outdoors on patches of natural ice. Snowbanks were used for boards and wooden posts for goals. Professional hockey, on the other hand, soon required indoor stadiums, artificial ice, and large paychecks. Many successful teams from smaller areas vanished. Instead, National Hockey League teams, which is a professional ice hockey league, emerged in larger cities in 1917.
Hockey is not only a symbol of Canada, but also a national sport and even a way of life. This country shines for having the ability to facilitate movement up and down the social ladder, freely by class or wealth. When it comes to hockey, it cannot be ignored in Canada, whether one appreciates the game or not. In every community, there are outdoor and indoor rinks. Being a player for the National Hockey League in Canada is part of the Canadian dream for millions of children across the country. However, for certain groups of people, in particular people from diverse racial backgrounds and lower social classes, indicates that the odds of making it are almost non-existent. The economical philosophy in Canada is about its capitalist economic system and its mixed market economy, which means that it relies both on the market and the government to distribute resources. It is argued that the economic system in Canada has an impact on hockey by being associated with profit. Large investors have increasingly put their interests ahead of the game, regardless of its interests of the fans. Either way, hockey is still a fundamental part of Canadian culture, and communities rally around it from coast to coast.
Football and basketball may be big business in many parts of the world, but in Canada it's all about hockey, and feeding that hockey habit is hardly cheap. There are $2.6 billion moving directly between the communities of Canada each year as a result of the sport. What really matters and gives the greatest economical impact is that more than $1 billion of that money flows in communities of less than 100,000 people, stimulating the growth and development of those cities, especially in remote regions. The average household spends $1,500 on hockey-related expenses each year, including kit, training, and club fees. And why wouldn't they? There are nearly 2,500 hockey rinks around the country, making it the densest country in the world in terms of rinks. These hockey rinks not only serve as a benchmark of Canadians' love of hockey, but also as a backbone, because they make more than 5,000 full-time jobs and attract more than 150,000 volunteers that spend an average of 5 hours a week on coaching, administration, and tournament-related tasks.
In countries like the US and Sweden, ice hockey becomes more and more important. However, it is still not as important as in Canada, where triumphs and great hockey players are still celebrated. In Canada, the people consider hockey to be their sport. Over the last century, men, women and children all over Canada have played the game with a lot of passion. In the Great White North, there is nothing above hockey. It decorates their currency, and many people are thinking and talking about it all year. Canadians perceive hockey as their cultural benchmark they often use to define themselves. This identification with the sport is what makes the love affair between hockey and Canadians so strong. Every win portrays the characteristics Canadians would like to see in themselves. However, every loss portrays the exact opposite. Hockey gives the Canadian people a sense of identity. This is something that is really important to them, because Canadians are often divided. Across the nation, little can be agreed upon, but when it comes to hockey, the Canadians are united.
One way of illustrating how important hockey is for some is back in 2011, there actually was a riot, the second in my city, which got quite violent, relative to most events here, which I think was really not a very violent city, and definitely not in terms of rioting. But there was a big event held downtown where people could view it's called the Stanley Cup, which is the big final hockey event of the year. And so it was Vancouver's team, and then that was the Boston Bruins. So the Vancouver Canucks and the Boston Bruins against each other. Quite a lot of alcohol and people watching these huge screens in the downtown core. And then lost, and I think there was some kind of disagreement with refs calls or something like that. There was just general dissatisfaction with how the game went, and people went insane. And so cop cars were burnt, they closed off the downtown core, riot police were called in, all that fun stuff. So I was supposed to go join friends downtown, and I just saw smoke. And I was like, well, I'm not going to go downtown. And that's the second time that's happened in the time I've been alive. So the only violence that I've ever really witnessed has either been because of hockey or during a hockey match, which I think is quite telling, for sure.